Of course, of course. Oh, and here is my dear friend, Arthur Callahan. Boy is a hunter. Boy is a killer. Arthur, you've met but not been introduced to Mr. Oh, I'm so sorry. Sheriff Gray.
How are you doing, sir?
I'm fine.
Tough business you boys had.
We did?
Oh, there's no need to pretend with me, sir. Life can be tough.
So it can.
And no man owes another anything.
No, sir.
But still, I feel you were hard done by. Losing your employment like that. But still, here in Rhodes, we have work enough for honest men.
Oh, that's some strong stuff. Still, don't seem to be doing you any harm, I guess.
Exactly. Whoa. Excuse me a moment.
I told you we was moving up in this world. Deputies.
You have finally lost your mind.
Amongst these drunkards, hillbillies, and slavers? Good honest thieves like us. We're bound to be moralizers in a place like this. Oh, Sheriff Gray, you are back.
Now listen, sir. There is shine in them woods, though. And it has cost in this county its good name. And the state a whole lot of income. You boys wouldn't mind rooting it out. Maybe we'll make you permanent. I gotta set me down a second.
Not a problem, sir. Not a problem at all. You are in safe hands now. And people waste time with the temperance movement. Liquor never dulled a good man's senses. Arthur, you ride with the deputy. Bill and I will follow.
Climb on up. Let's go.
Archibald,
how are you?
Pretty good.
And your friend is behaving himself?
Oh, yes. I think he's learned his lesson.
Congratulations on becoming a temporarily deputized citizen of Scarlet Meadows County. Most towns just get bounty hunters to do their dirty work these days, but Sheriff Gray believes the law should keep the law. Now, I'm sure I don't need to remind you there's a chain of command here.
There is?
Dang straight there is. This is a dangerous business, but follow my lead and you'll be just fine.
Sure. Hey! Archibald wants to remind us he's in charge here.
Of course!
Who else would be?
But you were a big help with them Anderson boys, and I put in a very good word with the sheriff on your behalf.
We appreciate that.
We rounded up the others soon after. I'm pushing for the rope myself, but that's by the by.
So, these moonshiners?
Not just any moonshiners. Braithwaites. I told you about the Braithwaites.
Pretty sure you did.
Old Cotton family had a fortune at one point until, well, a few changes in the labor laws. Now they're dealing in moonshine. We found their stills hidden all over Lemoyne. Quick as we destroy one, another one pops up. You could call it a pitiful fall from grace, if they had any grace to start with.
I have no time for tax dodgers.
Not to mention the fact that Catherine Braithwaite has a rather expensive interest in thoroughbred horses to maintain.
But I heard something about it being gold these families were fighting over.
Well, that's the rumor. But the Grays and the Braithwaites think the other stole a fortune from them. But it happened so long ago, I don't know for sure if it's true.
Must be tough being rich, huh?
So I imagine.
That badge rather suits you, Mr. W.
Yes. I thought so, too.
Does it feel good to be back at it, serving your country?
I wouldn't go that far.
Whoa! Whoa! Hold up. You see that wagon?
Flies! I swear they got it in for me.
You could try washing once in a while.
Oh.
Come on, mister. Keep your eyes open.
No, this must have happened recently.
Hey, come have a look at this.
Look, suit and tie, one bullet clean through the forehead. Well, my money says this is the handiwork of a gang called the Lemoyne Raiders.
Impressive. You got a keen eye.
Let's see if we've got any identification. Okay. We should get going. I'll send someone over here later to clean this up. Would you mind taking the reins? I want to have a look at these papers.
Sure.
I'll direct you. Okay. Frederick Mitchell, Lemoyne State Legislator. Poor feller. Yes, this certainly smacks of the Raiders to me. Bunch of ex-army freestaters without an ounce of respect for the law. That's 7 government officials they've murdered this year alone.
Well, sounds like you fellas got your work cut out for you around here.
Oh, and I know the Braithwaites are in business with them. No shame. Go right at the crossroads. Trash begets trash, my Uncle Reginald used to say. He had a few stories, let me tell you. Town preacher and town sheriff. Could drink a sailor under the table before breakfast. Bear right again here. He had one tiny hand, like a child's, on the end of a grown man's arm. But anyway, this tells you what kind of people the Braithwaites are, selling moonshine to murderers. I tell folks don't even speak to him. Don't even look him in the eye.
I'm sure I wouldn't.
Here we are. So what was I saying?
Something about the Braithwaites, I think.
Even saying that word makes me sick. Now, anyone we find here, we bring in alive, understood? Round them up and take this operation down for good. Come on, let's see what we're dealing with. See? See? What did I tell you, boys? What did I say? I said this place was crawling with vermin, and we just found ourselves the rat's nest par excellence, as they say in Paris. My aunt, she went to Paris back in 78.
I will handle this.
Well, the way I
see... Actually, let my friend here decide. He doesn't have your fine way with words, but he is definitely the man for the job.
Let's split up. Arthur and Bill, me and Archibald. You boys want right or left?
We'll take the left.
Let's stop these filthy, degenerate tax dodgers. The cheek of them.
A fine idea.
Remember what he said. We need them alive. Let's just knock them out and then tie them up.
Got it.
We'll take the left.
Let's stop these filthy degenerate tax dodgers. The chief.
Remember what he said. We need them alive. Let's just knock them out and then tie them up.
Got it, Deputy Williamson.
See one by the bridge over there? Bastard up. I think there's another one by the still.
Just drop him with the others.
I think that's it.
Well, what do we do now?
We better destroy all this. Any of your boys can handle explosives?
Sure. Anyone but him.
So, you think you're real funny, don't you?
Tell me about you.
That is the last time I'll mention it, I swear.
Starts.
see anymore. Do you?
No.
Let's find Dutch and get out of here.
Fine by me.
Are we getting out of here, then?
Well, forgive me, but me and my men must return to our lives. Ah, seems like we failed to destroy the last of the moonshine.
Sure.
Would you like us to?
Well, I normally take it for personal consumption. It's sort of part of the job. But I better get back home. Why don't I just take a jug or two and leave you boys the rest to show that there's no hard feelings on account of the war?
We are all Americans.
Of course. My cousin, Webster, he used to say some of us is not as American as others, if you know what I mean. Only I didn't quite. Come on, you degenerate, no-good, white-trash, hillbilly piece of scum. I know you, Billy Lime.
Finally.
You've always been a
Finally.
Piece of crap. Come on, move it.
We have a life on a land so stupid, a backwater so backwards that even we are like geniuses. Bill, get this stuff out of here. Come on. You ride with me.
Okay.
Should I stash this somewhere near camp, boss?
Yes! Show it to Hosea. I'm sure he can find a use for it. Bit of trouble back there, Arthur?
Ain't there always? From what they was yelling, I think they were the buyers.
Old Archibald didn't ask too many questions, so neither should we.
I ain't planning to.
That was worth the effort, though. Deputized and hiding in plain sight. These lawmen. These two families. I mean, I really think we can play this from all sides. It's got Hosea written all over it.
This is starting to sound like the young Dutch again.
What do you mean, young Dutch? I'm as strong as I have ever been. Hey, you know what? Why don't I race you back?
Okay, you're on.
That's the spirit. Okay. On my word. Set, go! You never were much of a rider.
We'll see about that.
Look out!
Okay, girl.
you were quite so good at running away, Arthur.
Oh, I never knew age had slowed you down quite so much.
Well, time is a bastard. When you get to be my age, well, you'll know that better than anything. Be well. I had fun with you today. I was gonna say you're like a son to me. But you're more than that.
You know, I think I've heard enough of your opinions, miss.
Is that so?
Yeah. Now make yourself useful. And the first part of useful is not driving me insane with your constant complaining.
I ain't complaining.
You are! Complain, complain, complain!
I ain't complaining.
I don't think this law disguise is fooling anyone.
You're not saying, miss. You're shouting.
Great. Oh, I'm sorry, Captain. Did they do things differently in the Navy?
Yeah. They left the ladies in port.
And you preferred that, did you?
Sometimes. Depending on the ladies. Should I say the women?
Oh, say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me, sailor, and I'll slice you up.
You put that knife down or you could be missing a hand.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, ain't cooking work?
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner.
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife.
Enough, both of you. Well, come with me then. You want to head out there, run with the man? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Pearson? Maybe me and Miss Zed are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list, and can you post this letter for me while you're there?
Sure. Come on, Princess. Are you coming with me then, woman?
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping?
Shut your goddamn mouth. Yeah. You cooled down then yet?
I guess. Now, I ain't no scullion, and I sure as hell ain't taking orders from that sweating half-wit.
I guess we all gotta do our share, Princess.
Where's that letter?
Are you reading his mail now?
Oh, robbing and killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
Mm-hmm. Here.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Ooh! Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talk to a woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, there. Now that's Dutch's idea.
All mail to be sent to the same alias.
Whenever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do.
Hey, watch it.
What the hell?
Careful now. Yeah.
Yep. Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
No! You insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws, not idiots. We rob fools that rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy some food to eat. And no guns.
You're sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
What did you get there, Harold?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? What's the
point? How's your look?
Too so.
Can I help you, mister?
Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
How do you do?
Hello?
My sister's newborn had more strength than you, and he came out bright blue.
I'm trying.
Try harder.
Hey, boy. Hey, boy.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here. Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
We'll give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help. Okay, get on. I'm about done here.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady. Get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know.
Y'all.
So, you get everything?
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see?
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you... you know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know. Nobody's taking nothing from... ever again.
Mm-hmm. Just don't kill the camp cook.
Hey there!
Hey.
What you folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool,
Sadie. You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this? Go, go, go!
God damn it! Get moving!
Thank you.
asking you to prove.
All I want paying a goddamn toll is you sons of bitches!
Lady, you are enjoying this too much.
There, see? Not many still standing
right,
now.
You goddamn coward!
I think we're good here, Arthur. I shoot. All right, I'll drive us back.
No, pass those reins here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine.
What a tough guy.
We hey, you want me to drive, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
You did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not. Yeah.
So who did they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Yeah, I've run into them before. Some local gang. Don't seem to have grown out of playing soldiers. Anyway, won't you go upsetting Pearson about that letter?
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want to peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
You didn't get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, we, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
You want to... Join us, Arthur?
Hey, Arthur, can I have a quick word?
Yes, Miss O'Shea.
Ah, call me Molly, would you? Arthur, how is Dutch? I mean, how does he seem to you?
I'm about the same as usual, I guess.
I really love him, you know. But if he... Like he always says, loyalty is everything, so...
Arthur! Excuse me, Miss O'Shea.
What you want?
I bring a gift. The great gift of information.
So you got some tip-off, so now I can risk my neck and make you some money while you lounge around.
You know, Arthur, bitterness, it works on the inside as well as on your sour face.
If you say so. But you could go find some other fool to run your errands.
Bill, come on over here. Will you be my other fool? You too, Charles.
What are you talking about?
Arthur's above a little stick-up I heard about.
No, I'm not.
You just said...
Hey, I'll do it. As long as you ride with us.
Well, I got a serious medical condition.
Yes, you are a compulsive liar.
No need to be like that. Charles, have I ever lied to you?
I hardly know you.
Exactly. Now, you boys should do this. It's easy, and I'll only take a small commission for my information. But it's now or never.
Then it's never.
Oh, God help me. Fine. I'll do it.
Well, what is it?
It's a supply wagon carrying payroll, but very briefly unguarded, apparently. As it passes through a crossroads near here where there's an old ruined church before it connects with the rest of the wagon train. Very easy pickings.
As long as we get paid or you get shot, I'm happy.
You are a sick man, Arthur Morgan. A very sick man indeed. This way.
bunch of smart alecks.
How you get wind of this, old man? We only been down here all of 5 minutes.
Well, you boys been off fishing or playing lawman. Whatever the hell you been doing, I've been getting down to business.
Finding the nearest grog house.
Hey, you don't want in on this, Williamson. That's fine by me. Do us all a favor. Head home.
Just give it a rest, you two.
Just have a little faith for once, will you? I've been scoping jobs like this since you fellas were knee-high to a grasshopper.
Once a decade, maybe. So what is it you've scoped here exactly?
Well, I told you. There's a wagon with a lockbox passes through every week. They switch outriders just north of here, but the front wagon's by itself for a stretch before the last run down into roads.
Okay, hold up here. We should cover our faces.
Well, they'll be passing through the crossroads up ahead.
When?
Soon, Williamson. Christ's sakes. I should be due any time now.
Let's keep this quiet and clean. Nobody needs to die here.
There! You see, gentlemen? Just like clockwork.
Oh!
Stop the wagon! I said, stop the damn wagon!
Whoa!
Now, don't try anything stupid! And we won't do anything unkind.
You know, boys, I don't want to get shot, but this is a mistake. I work for Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, Mr. Leviticus Cornwall.
Oh, great.
So you know him?
Who doesn't?
I hear he's rich enough to share the wealth around and not miss it too much.
Oh, he'll miss it.
Shit! Hey, think I see something?
Oh, great.
Let's go!
Arthur, let's go! Yeah!
Hold it right there!
Yeah!
Drop your goddamn weapon! Right now! You blink, you son of a bitch!
Ride, fellas! Come on!
Y'all made a big mistake!
Well, nice going, Uncle! Most guarded wagon in goddamn history!
How'll I know?
They're still on us! Keep on us!
Yeah!
Get in!
Out of shot, boys! Get rid of these sons of bitches!
You're going to shoot those bastards!
Keep going! Got some breeze on that one!
Slow down, sons of bitches!
Where the hell are we going?
Getting out of here! What kind of dumb questions? Keep going! We're losing them!
Yeah.
Faster, come on! Get back here!
You can move fast when you have to, Kick! Quick! Get off the trail!
Into the woods!
Let's shake him and get back to camp!
No, we need to find a place to lie low. We can't risk leading Cornwall's men to camp.
All right.
Whoa.
Let's hide in here. Quick.
What? Hey.
Get out of here.
Get out of here. Go on. See you later. All right. Let's get out of sight. Stay until dark, and then we'll sneak out of here.
Charles, you keep watch for now.
Sure. Well, we get some rest. Yeah. All right. Let's try and get out of here.
Hey, shit!
Absolutely. Well, shut up, old man.
Look, I was just trying to...
Shut up. There's a light. Over by the house.
Damn! I ain't in there. Let's just keep this calm. See what happens.
Is this your place?
kinda. And you didn't hear nothing? Why don't you just tell me, partner, what you heard?
Go ahead. Tell me what you heard.
I don't... Maybe I heard some noises out by the barn a while ago. Ain't me.
Better not be. All right. Coop forth. Lo, go check out the barn.
Sir.
Place looks deserted enough.
Sure. You head inside, I'll go around the back.
Place looks empty to me. Now, the old guy up there is full of crap.
I don't think they're here. Don't see any horses.
Come on, let's head back. Boss! Place is empty!
Shit!
Looks like we're shooting our way out of here, fellas!
Yeah, I hope you're ready to die!
That's how you want to do it? Behind you, Charles! More on the right here!
Where are they all coming from?
Looks like Mr. Cornwall's gone and up to security.
We got more of the bastards on this side. This fella really don't like getting robbed.
Let's just hope we don't run.
Shoot him!
Nicely done, Bill. They teach you that move in the army, too?
Can't you keep your fat feet still for 10 goddamn seconds?
You got us into this!
Put a bullet in the...
How about we stop robbing Cornwall for a while?
I didn't know we was robbing Cornwall, all right? That one almost hit you.
Ain't you glad now I insisted you come along?
Oh, this is it. I'm officially retired. Damn it, they're piling in this way now!
Another one! I've got this, Uncle.
You're breathing your last breath!
What now?
Hold them back! Do not let them close in on us!
Shit! Fire!
Watch out!
Split up a bit. Try
confuse him. Arthur, with me.
Anything, Doug Williamson, you're on your own.
Oh, shut the hell up.
Quick, behind these rocks.
They're coming this way.
Perfect.
We need to do this quietly. You take the left and I'll take the right, okay?
You're right or my right?
You see anything?
Not yet. Mr. Cornwall,
bastard! Get the hell off me! Arthur!
Made a meal out of that, didn't you?
This is a young man's game.
Son of a bitch!
Uh-oh. Clearly those boys ain't as quiet as...
Guess we should go give him a hand.
It's over for you! I'm gonna kill you, Shelby!
Go to hell!
Just about.
Yeah, I'll deal with you later.
We got some money, didn't we?
Sure, but now we got Cornwall on our backs.
It was an honest mistake.
Hey, leave it. Go on, get out of here. Every man split up. Go on, run quick.
Good luck, gents.
Stay quiet and move.